All right, we're just doing a little bicycle ride around town. It's Thursday afternoon. It's kind of cold. Here's my setup, as y'all all know. Let's get rolling. I don't know where we're gonna go. We're just gonna decide as we go. Probably stick around in town. Vamanos. Let's vamanos. Turn on my GPS and track how far I'm going. Strava. Blustery day, it's windy. See that flag? It's wind coming out of the north. So I'm just gliding along pretty effortlessly right now. Don't want to go too fast on these city streets because of all the cross streets that can have people on them that might come out and just hit me from the side, T-bone me. So I go slow and drive defensively, ride defensively. I'll do it. Good, thanks. Thank you. All right, so we're gonna go. We're clear. I think we may go to the Medal of Honor Trail. Big old rock in the road with my
both tires.
Quite a bump.
Quite a bump.
This ankle's feeling really good. It's really healing up nicely. It's not perfect, but it wasn't perfect before the injury, so it's getting pretty close to where it was. With the exception of the discomfort that those metal plates and screws are causing, I'm pretty darn happy with how it went. It's kind of a necessary evil that we can remove later on. Thank you. What kind of doggy do we have here? It's like a schnauzer. Nah, that's something else. It's not big though. Oh, it's a puppy. Cute puppy. Looks like it may be like a mixed breed with some German Shepherd and maybe some Bulldog in it. I don't know. Definitely gonna be bigger than he is now. He's full grown. We're gonna go to that big hill on Burn City Road that leads up to 902. That's where we're gonna go. I'm gonna see if I can climb that hill. Look out for traffic. We're clear. Yeah, I want to climb that hill because I've got a tailwind and it's always hard to climb, you know, even, you know, without a broken ankle. I'm about 9 weeks post surgery on that deal right now, so. Having a missing leg on the right side, on the other side, that's a challenge that I've gotten really good at mastering. But since I've lost so much strength in the real leg because of the broken ankle and leg, having to spend so much time just laying in bed, letting the wound, the breaks and the wounds heal, that's my power source, that leg, and now it's weaker, so. It's gaining strength every day, so we're going to see if we're ready to climb that hill. If not, we'll just turn around and go back down. But because there's no gravel on it, I can pretty much depend on what I can predict what to expect, as opposed to these country gravel roads where they just lay down new gravel sometimes going up the road and spin out. Now we know there's no gravel on it, and there is a headwind. So wait for this truck to pass, and I'm gonna get on across the road on the trail. All right. Sorry if y'all don't like the music on this video. I only have a very limited selection and I don't know how to use more than one song on it. Some of my videos are an hour long, the same song repeating over and over again. I realize that, it's just what my editing capabilities are at right now, so. That's the deal with that. Man, I never noticed this big dog pen back here. There's a like an 8-foot fence. It's kind of new. They just set it up. Looks like a dog pen. Sure there's no oncoming traffic. Wind's kind of dying down a little bit. That's a tattered flag right there. Look at that. It's kind of faded, tattered. But that's okay, you know, a lot of people get bent out of shape when they see a tattered American flag. I see every wounded soldier that fought for that flag to keep it flying. When I see a tattered flag, I see a injured soldier. Whoa, this car was just parked. Decided to take off. All right, so now, crossing Anthony Street, or this is the end of Anthony Street. This that we're getting onto now is Burn City Road. It's got a good shoulder on it. Still gotta really watch the traffic though. So one time I was riding right here, or a little further up around this bend, and there was a car oncoming that was texting, and it came right into the shoulder head on at me, and they didn't realize, you know, that I was here because they were texting. And so I had to jump up over the curb into the grass. But if that person had come at me from behind, if I had been going the other way, it would have gotten me for sure. It would have plowed me over.
about right here where that happened.
All right, y'all, so we got a big hill up there. That's what we're gonna climb. I'm 9 weeks post surgery for my broken leg and trimalleolar ankle fracture. I've got 15 screws, 2 metal plates in that leg. It's my only good leg, my only real leg. Other leg's a prosthetic leg. We're gonna try to climb this hill. It's probably the steepest hill I've tried to climb since the accident. Right up there. How's it going, ladies and gentlemen? All right, so I'm 9 weeks post-surgery for my broken leg and complex trimalleolar ankle fracture. I'm gonna try to climb this hill the first time. Well, this is the steepest hill and longest hill I've tried to climb since my accident. Since my only real leg had to spend 6 weeks completely non-weight bearing, this may be a challenge, but I'm building strength and I think I can do it. Let's see. We'll find out. There's only one way to find out. Let's just do it. Let's just try it. Let's see. All right, now we're climbing. We've got a tailwind, but it's still really steep. All right, I'm gearing it down. All right, we're going. We're halfway there. Gearing it down all the way. All the way. So I'm feeling good. I could make it like this without even using my trekking pole. Makes a big difference having a smooth surface instead of a rough gravel surface. However, I'm going to use my trekking pole right here. And the reason I do that is to save my good knee. It kind of stresses it out, you know, my only real knee. So let's say I'm doing a 200 mile race with a bunch of hills like this. Well, then all of a sudden, if I'm going into headwinds and not using my trekking pole, it'll wear out my good knee before the race is done. Start swelling up and hurting. But we're not going very far today. We're just doing a few miles around town. Maybe a little gravel. Don't really need to use the trekking pole. See that wind? It's helping me. Man, that was easier than I thought it would be. We're not quite there, but we're leveled out enough to where it's gotten real easy now. Still climbing. No danger of not making it though. All right, so once we pass this road right here, we're officially at the top. This driveway, mailbox, this flag. And we passed it all, so now we officially made it to the top of the mountain, the hill. Ha ha ha. Decide what to do next. Should I turn around or go on up here to a gravel road? I think I'll go on up here to the gravel road. It's got a lot of traffic here though. I'm gonna get over on the other side.
Nobody behind me. Got some downhill and tailwind. It's gonna take me to this gravel road up here. Then we'll use the gravel road to go over to Old Denton Road. Nobody behind me still. Still clear from behind. That's good. Slow down and turn off right here. Gives us a little bit of gravel. Yeah. Oh man, we're going right back into that wind. Now it's a headwind. Drive a truck or a motorcycle, you just don't notice headwinds because they don't affect your end result that much. You may get a little, spend a little more on gas going into a headwind, but when it's all you, all your muscle power, boy, you really feel it. Makes a world of difference. Headwinds versus tailwinds, crosswinds. Coming up behind me. Twin Bridges Road right here. That's one of the bridges. Thank you. Pup, how you doing? So here we are at Old Denton Road. No cars coming to the left or the right. Get over here. So you can see that traffic coming. Oh, now we're going into the wind. A mailbox right there. Somebody wants a free mailbox. It's in the ditch. It's got a post on it and everything. The post is rotted out on the bottom, but otherwise a good mailbox. Luckily that dog was on a chain. I thought it was gonna come after me. Those Australian Shepherds, you know, they're great dogs. I've had an Australian Shepherd, but they will nip at your legs, bite you in the leg, and man, I can't afford that with all this metal I've got in my only good leg. If I get a dog bite, I could get an infection and lose the leg or have to have emergency surgery to get all the metal taken out. So, gotta really protect my good leg, my real leg, from dog bites. Can't just take a bite. Gotta stop that dog before it does bite me.
other side. Downhill right here, but boy, we're sure going into a headwind. It's coming out of the northwest. We're headed west. So up here we're gonna turn right, which is north, and we'll be headed right back into it still. Nice hay bales. I think it's Johnson grass, hey? Looks good to me. So, you want to buy it? Don't talk to me. I can't direct you where to go. Thank you.
7 miles so far. Now we're straight into the wind. Nothing to block it. Flat, but it was a little uphill and it was straight up against the wind. You can see how it's blowing right there. We're still going against it a little bit. Not too bad. Thank you. gonna turn on to Denton Street. Head back to the north, into that wind again. Thank you. Well, I got a car coming up behind me. So I'm gonna get on over here. Cross right here, get up onto this sidewalk. Now I can go. That's what I'm gonna do. Good. Clear. Clear. Someone behind me. Busy now, so I better be careful. I think I'm ready to get on out of here. Okay, so I'm gonna cross, clear. Thank you. All right, so we've gone 9.15 miles. Went for about an hour, so we didn't quite go 10 miles an hour. We went over 9 miles an hour. We weren't trying to be fast. We're trying not to get killed or hit by cars. Trying to fight those winds and go up those hills. So this concludes my video surveillance of this bicycle ride.